Noon, the Department of Justice wants to know whether Pennsylvania's new voter ID law complies with federal laws. Assistant U.S. Attorney General Thomas Perez wrote to state officials yesterday to request information about the law, which says a voter must show an eligible photo ID card for his or her vote to be counted. Among other things, the Department of Justice wants to see if state officials try to determine how many people don't have a legal ID for voting. And the Department of Justice's inquiry comes at the same time the NAACP is preparing to hold a rally today to protest the new voter ID law. News 8 Dauphin County reporter Porcha Johnson is live in the state capitol where the rally is set to begin shortly. Porcha.
Well, Jerry, the rally begins within the next hour, and people from all over the state are expected to gather here, right here on the Capitol steps behind me. You can probably see the news media that's setting up right now. Now, this is everyone here will have the same message, and that is to overturn this new voter ID law. Now, the law requires voters to show acceptable ID during this year's election. I'm here joined here with John Jordan with the NAACP of Pennsylvania. And can you pretty much explain to why you feel that this is a direct attack on voter rights?
We feel it's a direct attack because it's strategic and it's targeted to disenfranchise women, people of color, students, and seniors. And we're just not going to stand around and allow it to happen. So we're calling this rally today to bring as much attention to it prior to tomorrow's hearing and to hopefully, you know, have someone understand that this thing needs to be overturned.
Now if this was not a presidential election year, do you think that this law would be fair?
No, not at all. Okay. Not without the proper, this law was not very well thought out. It was, like I said, it was strategic and targeted, but not very well thought out. Students 18 to 25, we surveyed 114 universities, 95 of them didn't have expiration dates. Seniors that have been voting all their lives, all of a sudden, that is being snatched away from them. And women are very transient, and now the two forms of residency, two proofs of residency requirements, it's just a lot. And especially for people that weren't born here in Pennsylvania, it becomes a real burden to have to pay other states, especially southern states, that didn't issue birth certificates to African Americans.
Thank you so much, John, for joining us today. And just as John mentioned, tomorrow the Commonwealth Court will hold a hearing on that lawsuit to block this new voter ID law. Back to you, Jerry.
All right, we'll see what happens. Porcha, thank you. We'll see.